Okay, now we need to jack this bad boy up and get the front wheel off. And we'll take the front wheel off with the impact gun wherever. Oh, there it is. We'll take it off and we'll proceed to take the brake caliper off. And well, you'll see in the next few clips. So, how much play does this wheel bearing have? Let's find out. Not a whole lot, but it's got some, and they're not tapered. I don't even think taper bearings would have this much. They have just the slightest bit of play, but nothing like this. That's off. Come on there. There goes that. Just got stuck on there actually. And so here's the cool part. Bye bye, rusty rotor. Oh man. Just got freaking bugs in here. Yeah. It's definitely not bad. Okay, so now we're working on the third bolt. You know, it seems like for a front end, I should have like four, but I guess three doesn't. So anyways, this wire here is your ABS wire. We'll just take it off from here. And it runs all along here. And it's this guy here, and it goes up here and plugs in somewhere. I think it goes up even further. Shit. Wish this was two-wheel drive. Actually, no, I take that back. Because if it was two-wheel drive, I'd have to do the taper bearing bullshit. Or whatever. This is easier. I can just unbolt it and slap the new one on and be done with it. Want to hear what a bad bearing sounds like? Doesn't sound too good to me. Oh yeah, the little plastic things here that hold this on to the frame. Yeah, well, come with new ones. So on your old setup, go ahead and pull the fuckers out. Pull every single one out and just pop them back in. So, yeah. One thing to note when you pull the old bearing off or assembly, it has a little black O-ring around it. Make sure you save that if it's still good, and this one looks like it is in perfect condition. Just wipe it down a little bit and she's ready to go. And we do have the right connectors. That's good. That would be kind of stupid. It's like, you know, if it's for this model, it says for this VIN or whatever. Come on, guys. No. But yeah, she sounds a little better. She sounds nice and new, I guess. I don't know. I mean, it could be new. I don't know. All right. Let's do this. Now on the old bearing, your little connector here goes behind the shield. So make sure that you get that right. Can only really go in one white. Get that behind there. Oh wow, it even comes with a new thing, man. Where are we set? This guy. This little guy here is a real pain in the ass. Okay, that'll be good enough. So now this is gonna plug in like that, and then we've got, you know, slack for movement. Should be plenty there. That gets plugged in there. And that gets plugged in there. Boom! Brand new wires and new connectors. So now we just get to tighten this thing up and we get to work on brakes. Check this out. Here's the old pad. Here's how much meat they had on them. Not too bad. It's half as much as the new pads. But these bad boys were suffering from heat cracks. And also it looks like the actual pad was just starting to separate from the frame of it. Alright, I got new pads and new rotors. Well, got the brakes to work. I bled them out. I had to have my cousin Adam come by and help me bleed the brakes. We did run into a bit of a snag with the passenger side caliper. Stupid bleeder screw didn't want to come undone, so the fix was to just replace the caliper. And so it was $37. So I just went ahead and replaced the caliper, and so now it's got a new wheel bearing on the passenger side, new rotor, new brake pads, and a new freaking brake caliper. So yeah, now I'm just taking it for a test drive. Right now it's riding pretty good. It's not shaking a whole lot. It's actually doing a lot better. So yeah, now we just need to take care of some other stuff. Oh man, look at his antlers. Well, anyways, that's it for this car video. I'll give you a test drive later. Hope you can see this, but over there, it's me! Just different rims. Haha. Look, 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 there I am!